Okay, so maybe you are the cursor fanboy who was using cursor for a while, but recently got rug pulled because all the pricing drama. Or maybe you are a Windsurf fanboy and you are happily using Windsurf only to find one day their whole CEO team has ditched Windsurf and joined Google. Who is controlling Windsurf? Who knows? Cursor gone and Windsurf. They were about to have a deal with OpenAI and that the future was so bright. But now, all the top team of Windsurf has joined Google. So, what do we do? Do we keep using Cursor or is there a better alternative? Well, there is. If you have seen the thumbnail, maybe I provided it there. But let's get into it. Enter our biggest help, Claude Code. So, yeah, I'm a convert now. I've been using it for more than 2 weeks now. And I am a convert. I didn't pay much attention to it, but it is really awesome. And before we dive into this Claude Code thing, let me first tell you why Claude Code. So let me open Xcalidraw. What are we here for? We're here for agentic coding setups. We need to be using a good, stable agentic coding setup. And there are two things which are important for it. One is the underlying model. And what is second? It is, and this could be things like your actual model, which could be like Claude Sonnet or Opus, GoIn models, which are new ones. So these are the underlying models which we can use. This will decide how smart our brain is going to be. But second, more important thing in case of all these agentic coding tool is tool calling. What is this? This is a way to pro. I'm not gonna go deeper into tool calling, but it is the way our app, like our Cursor, Windsurf, and all these CLI apps which are coming, Aider, Klein, Rucode, all of these, any other thing you can imagine. So these implement tool calling in a good or bad way. All tool calling setups are not equal. So there's no reason that just because all of these tools are using the same model, let's say Claude Sonnet, for example, there's no reason that they will give the exact same performance. So you need to be always be on the lookout for which app is trending. So for a while, Cursor was the one trending. They did really well on tool calling, and they were using a good model underneath. We could change the model, but they were using a good model. So these are the two things. And our aim, what's our aim? Our aim is to have a stable experience with what? With the state of the art models. So we know for models, there are just three top companies. You could have the Anthropic by Claude, you could have the Gemini models by Google, or you could have the, oh, I missed the main ones, which are O3 by OpenAI. There are only top three companies doing this. We have a very good open source ecosystem also brewing, but if you need state-of-the-art proprietary models, these three companies are the top ones. So that is clear. But all these apps support all the models. So that is not really a differentiator. What you need to be looking for is which tool is giving us the best tool calling. And we have all these companies which are third-party companies, and then enters Anthropic with their Claude Code setup. Now, why is this different from others? And even recently we got Gemini Code, Gemini CLI. Why are these different? Well, these are different because the same people who actually built the model, trained the model, knows the model in the best possible way, they are the ones building the tool calling for these models. And that's why using Claude Code with Sonnet or Opus hits way different and way better and way smarter compared to Cursor and Windsurf and Aider and Rucode and Klein. And recently we also got one more that you should be aware of, which is Kilo Code. This is also nice. These are open source, and these are closed source, and these are also closed source. So the two things which we need are, that's just to recap. One is what we need. We need models, but everyone has the models. All apps have the models. What's the second thing we need? Great tool calling. Now, great tool calling, we are having great VC-funded startups which are doing this, or you can just use the one by Anthropic. So that is one of the benefit, where if Anthropic does it, they do it better because they are the ones building the model. Cool. So I can write tool calling by company building the model. Cool. Well, there is one more benefit, which is the cost. Now, the thing is, Claude and Gemini, like Anthropic and Google have Cursor and Windsurf really in their fist. They have them in their fist. Tomorrow, Claude can 10x their API cost or half their API cost and can decide how will Cursor and Windsurf perform. So if API cost for Claude Code goes up, Cursor usage goes up and Cursor is in a loss and can just die. That's what also recently happened, leading to Cursor tweaking their pricing model and making it work. And that's the third benefit, pricing. If you're directly paying your $20 to Anthropic and using their pro subscription to use Claude Code, you get way more usage than you will get with Cursor or Windsurf or all these other tools. These are actually out of the park because with these, you actually need to use the API. And API is way expensive compared to just a pro subscription. I'll tell you how also. So the thing is, there are two ways to use Claude Code or Gemini. One is you just directly use the API pricing, and this is going to be expensive. And the other way is just using the pro subscription or the max subscription. And this is only $20. And this could be pay as you go. So I can tell you my current usage, just to give you an example of how it's going. There is this beautiful tool made in open source, which is called CC Usage, which can tell you your latest and full usage. So as you can see, I started from, so this was my 2 days of API usage where I realized it's gonna get really expensive. And from third, I actually switched to a Claude Pro subscription. And you can see from third up till today, I only paid 20 and I've used more than $126 worth. And this is just in the last 20 days. I still have 10 days to go. So this is gonna go way up. So as you can see, this is way cheaper. If I was paying using the API pricing, just API pricing, plain API, I would have paid the exact amount, which is $126, but I didn't have to. You have to know a few things, like it has Windows, it needs a cooldown period. That's all important, but I think Pro subscription is good enough for most developers to work with this. So yeah, that's the reason you should be using Claude Code now, Claude Code, instead of your Windsurf or Cursor. Or you could be like me. I use both. As you can see, this is actually Cursor. What I've opened here is Cursor. You can see Cursor tab complete. I'm not paying for it, but I still have it open. And what I did was, on the right-hand side, you can see my terminal. This is where I have put my terminal. And I can just start using Claude inside it. Why not use both? And you can see here also, this is the Claude Code extension to make it work. Okay, connected. So yeah, this is also good. That is also good. Let me exit. And now, coming back to Claude Code. Okay, so when I myself heard Claude Code for the first time, I was thinking, hell no, I'm not a Vim guy. I do like the power of Vim and I respect people who can use Vim and move really fast in editing, but I'm not the one who can move really fast. So I was thinking that this has a terminal UX and I will not like it. This is a terminal UX. I will not like it. But what happened is I was really pleasantly surprised to use Claude Code's UX. I don't have to tell you to use it. Just use it directly. Don't take my word for it. You can see it's connected now. And it's got a very good integration with your IDE also. So even if you have VS Code or Cursor, let's say I select this file. I can press Option Command K, and you can see the same file is in my context here. What is this doing? I can ask. I can do whatever. And it will start sending the model and come back. A lot of things which it enables. You can see I have the bash mode. So if I'm not gonna be trying all of this, but just to show you a small example. With exclamation, it goes into bash mode, and you could have custom commands to do whatever. I have one command just to simply generate the Git. If I have something staged, some files staged, I can use this command to generate a commit message. I was just practicing how to use Claude Code. So it gives you very good benefits. It allows you to use hooks that we will get into in a future video. That is truly the real power. So here you can see it gave me the whole command that we can use. This is actually the whole Git commit that I can simply commit. And it's also gone into the bash mode to actually commit it. If I say yes, it's going to commit this, which I don't want to. So I'm just going to say no. Cool. So coming back to this is the reason we should be using Claude Code. Now, in my future videos, I will get into how to use Claude with not just Claude Sonnet and Claude Opus. if you have a keen eye, you may have noticed something here called Moonshot AI Kimi K2, or even Gemini 2.5 Pro. I was using Claude Code with Gemini 2.5 Pro and Moonshot AI's Kimi K2. We are going to get into that in the next video, but for now, if you're not already, start using Claude Code, and you don't have to stop using Cursor. You can use Claude Code inside Cursor, and I'll see you in the next one. Thank you. And please subscribe. And please subscribe if you need more such info, and I will be putting out more videos to explain. And I think the AI setups are moving really fast, the agentic AI setups. If you want to stay on of all the latest setups, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.